What's going on, everybody? And in this video, I want to talk about the latest version of the iOS, the iOS 12.1, running on the iPad, and all of the things you need to know about it. So let's begin with this video right now. So the iOS 12.1 has been released a couple days earlier, but right now I wanted to make a video about this latest version running on the iPad and everything specific just to the iPad. So I don't want to talk about the features that are present on the iPhone but are not present on the iPad, only things that have to do something with this bigger iOS running device. So let me show you what it looks like. So this is the prompt to update in the settings. You can see that the size of this one is 350 megabytes roughly, and I was updating from iOS 12.0.1, so the previous version was installed on this device. Okay, so let's take a look at the storage before and after the update. So you can see this screenshot has been made while this device was running the previous iOS 12.0.1. You can see that the capacity, of course, was 16 gigabytes just like usual, but the available was at 860 megabytes. And after the update, you can see that the actual version is 12.1. You can see that we have lost more than 100 megabytes just for nothing, and that's why this update isn't very good in terms of the storage. But if there are good features, then nobody cares about the storage. Now, what are the new features or the new things that affect the iPad? Of course, group FaceTime has been added in this version, and many people are excited about it because many people use the iPad and its big screen for phone calls or video calls using FaceTime. So that's why it's really great that Apple finally added the support for group FaceTime. And of course, newer iPads are having really good screen, and they are also improving the front-facing camera. That's why people are enjoying video calls or FaceTiming their friends. One of the bigger features that have come with the iOS 12.1 are the 70 new emojis. Apple claims that there are 70 new emoticons that have been added to the keyboard of the iPad and of course of the iPhone, but it has to do with the iPad. So that's why I'm talking about it. So this one hasn't been here before, and also some other, there are plenty of them. For example, this one wasn't here as well. But if you want to be like really in depth with this, then take a look at the description of my video, and there will be a link that's gonna take you to a website. It's called Emojipedia, and there you can keep track of all of the emojis you could ever think of, and that's why this is probably the best website for emojis. And there you can see everything that has been changed, all of new ones, and all of the things you need to know about emojis. By the way, if you are new here and this is your first time on this channel, consider subscribing, because I try to post similar content like this. I try to keep you updated with your iPhone, iPad, and also your Apple Watch. Not really iPod Touch, because nobody uses that. Anyways, if you want to stay updated, just smash the subscribe button, and we're gonna see each other in the next video. Not only did we get some new emojis, but also some of the older ones got updated and got a new look. For example, this one is the emoji of the iPhone, and now you can see that it doesn't have the bezel and it simply represents the new iPhone X, and it is present in the iPhone XS and XR basically. So it looks a lot better, it looks a lot cleaner, and that's why Apple decided to do it this way. And Apple is definitely updating some little things inside the OS that many people won't even notice. Like, take a look at this. Use as wallpaper has also got a new toggle that looks like the iPhone X. It doesn't have to do anything with the iOS 12.1. We have seen this earlier, but Apple continues with this pattern, and they are switching up the old looks of the phones and of the emojis inside the iOS, and they are bringing the new modern look. Ironically, these also represent phones. You can see this one and the one under it, but these haven't received the new look of the iPhone X, and they are still showing the old bezel iPhone that we are used to from the past. The reason why I like to make videos specific to one device regarding the iOS is because not every single thing is present on every single version of the iOS. Let me explain. On the iPhone, I may have the very same version of the OS running, but not every single feature that is present on the iPhone is also part of the iPad. For example, in the iOS 12.1, if you just click on this toggle right here, on the iPhone lock screen, you also get a sound. And we don't have that options on the iPad just because we don't have that user interface. Of course, it could have been part of the huge display of the new iPad Pro, but unfortunately it isn't. Also, the portrait mode in the iOS 12.1 got some new features where you can adjust the blurriness of the photo that you can take, but on the iPad, of course, it doesn't work because we don't even have the portrait mode at first place. The dual SIM support is starting to make its way to the public, but again, it's not part of this device. According to the description of this update, we know that this update also focuses on fixing the bugs and some issues, and it also improves some things, but I'm not really aware of what exactly has been changed in terms of the security. But for this, we have to click on the link that's going to take us to Apple's website, and there you can read everything there is to know about security patches within this iOS. And the security content of the iOS 12.1 actually explains everything. You can read it on your own, so you can see iPad Air and later, so you can see that many of the things are also part of the iPad, and it's just not for the iPhone but for the iPad as well. Pretty much every single one of these is also patched or has been resolved for the iPad as well. And this right now would be everything what I wanted to mention in this video. I really hope you found it informative and useful, and if you want to see more content like this, don't forget to subscribe to this channel, don't forget to help this video with a thumbs up, and stay tuned for the next updates and the next videos. Have a nice day and see you in the next one. Peace out, guys.